Welcome everyone. In this session, we will go through the latest major developments regarding the recently released ANSA version 24.1.0. These enhancements are in the areas of modular run management, meshing, and multiple others like durability, crash and safety, CFD, or user productivity. We will start right off with modular environment and whatever that relates to modular run management. ANSA version 24.1.0 brings improved usability of the Save in DM functionality. When saving a model browser container in DM, using the silent save functionality, and the definition of a comment is marked as mandatory through the modular environment settings, the missing comments window opens, prompting the user to define a comment for each of the model browser containers that are modified, magenta update status, and lack a comment value. It is possible to append the contained model browser container's comments to their parent. This is achieved by enabling the Apply Comments to Parents checkbox. The maintenance and cleanup operations of the DM database have been substantially enhanced in version 24.1.0. It is now possible to recursively delete all simulation runs and all their contents through a single operation, provided that they are not used by other DM objects. When a compound model container is selected for deletion, the user can also select which of its contents to delete based on their type. The contents are collected and a preview of the objects to be deleted is offered, as well as information on which objects cannot be deleted in case they are used by other DM objects. In order to facilitate team collaboration when remote users cannot be connected to a common, central DM constantly, or are not granted write permissions to the central DM, we had introduced in version 21.0.0 the Send to DM function. With this function, selected content from a central DM can be transferred to a local DM so that the users work on this data extraction offline. Data produced in the local DM as new iterations of previously transferred data can be pushed back to the central DM. In version 24.1.0, we have optimized this functionality, offering improved robustness and performance. In previous versions of the beta suite, we introduced the DM Tree Focus functionality, which can isolate and focus only on specific parts of the data structure that represent the current working projects without the need of specifying any filters. It essentially focuses data browsing on particular branches of the data tree. This tool, originally applicable to simulation models lists only, has now been enhanced and extends its applicability to all simulation data of the DM repository. When the user activates it, the DM Tree Focus window works as it used to. It presents in a tree structure all the attributes of existing simulation data for the user to browse through the tree and activate the branches of interest. On OK, the lists are adapted accordingly. When the DM Tree Focus is enabled, the lists of subsystems, models, runs, etc. are affected, narrowing down the listed items so as to include only the data of interest. In this version, centralized management of the settings of all client applications of the beta suite is offered when SPDRM is used as a simulation data management backend. With the new functionality, an ANSA, combos, or meta session gets configured by reading the settings from the SPDRM library. The association of different settings with different user roles is offered, so that according to the role of the user connected to SPDRM, different sets of settings are fetched, if required. In the new launcher that appears when ANSA is launched with the DM root option, the user may select among only the settings profiles available to their role. A new feature is available in ANSA Meta DM Browser or in Combos in order to compose an overview report. This report can be either a single report of the performance of a simulation model, load case, or run, or it can be a comparison report of the above-mentioned entities. The tool makes use of a template in PPTX format and fills it with values, images, and tables which are stored in DM under these entities. The option is available in the context menu of such entities. As an example, the option overview report can be selected for a simulation run. The PPTX template may contain some text placeholders in text boxes and tables or some image placeholders. The information how these placeholders should be filled with data is defined in the attributes of the various PPTX shapes and is stored inside the PPTX file. The tool retrieves the necessary DM reports based on this information and fills the overview report to view it and save it later as PPTX, HTML, or PDF file. As a second example, the option is used on two simulation runs. In this case, the template is set up to be filled with data from two runs to facilitate their comparison. There are separate placeholders for the data of run 1 and of run 2. The DM reports are once again retrieved and fill the report as shown here. We switch to meshing. Regarding casting, a new tool has been developed that automatically identifies thick areas of casted parts based on a user-defined thickness threshold value. During middle mesh generation, on areas specified as thick, a volume skin of Trios is created, in order to generate tetramesh. Volume skin is connected to the middle mesh of neighbor areas, resulting in a shell tetrahybrid result. Handling complex casting parts is a time-consuming process in general. For this reason, new functions have been developed and are available in the middle mesh menu, to make this process simpler and faster. Automatic partition of the model into subparts is implemented. The workload is assigned to different engineers, who work in parallel on the different partitions. When the users finalize their subpart, all the partitions are merged back into the original part. Since ANSA version 24.1.0, the process is performed without the need to use ANSA DM functionality. Bended extruded result can now be produced by the automatic middle mesh generator tool via the corresponding option, bended extrusion. In addition, the GUI window of the tool is further enhanced. A new tool that automatically identifies and fixes intersecting solid structural mesh creating compatible mesh is now available. In addition, on non-intersecting interface areas, compatible mesh can also be created on demand. Via a new flag introduced in mesh parameters, the zones around holes 3D features can have either ortho or normal trios. It is now possible to automatically create conformal solid mesh on stacked parts via two new plugins. Mesh Planar Stack, which is responsible for creating planar stack parts. Mesh Flex Stack is responsible for flex components, as depicted. Both tools provide the capability to automatically create base. Edit the mesh on base. Automatically create conformal solid mesh of various types. Automatically fix any penetration errors or gaps between components and to re-refine the thickness. Regarding map block functionality, the minimum number of rows on the round areas can be defined via a new argument. In addition, it is now possible to directly create washers upon map block, around already recognized holes 3D features. Regarding computational fluid dynamics, the layers algorithm has been enhanced in order to provide better and smoother blending of heights between areas with different user specifications, like for example areas with wall function and Y+1 layers. Layers now provide the functionality for users to specify a variable first height in a radial direction. The off inspector functionality is now also provided for surface mesh. Under Elements Inspect, the user can access this tool in order to have a full picture of all violating elements and be able to isolate them, inquire them with respect to their quality criteria values, and also send them for quality improvement. A new tab has been added in Mesh Parameters for CFD Batch Mesh Sessions that allows the user to specify 3D curve size rules in order to specify the direction and magnitude of the anisotropy in a given direction. This allows the user to tailor exactly the mesh length values along and away from a curve rule, thus capturing all geometrical curvature with the minimum number of elements. Furthermore, regarding isogeometric analysis, areas where crosstalk effect takes place are now colored in red rectangular span regions. Crosstalk effect takes place on holes, notches, where there is no sufficient number of knot spans across material gaps. Locating these areas is important for IGA analysis. The new merge patch option creates a single underlying IGA 2D NURBS XYZ for multiple IGA face XYZ. A new checkbox that check stitch edges enables automatic stitching of the IGA edge UVW within a tolerance. The negative Jacobian areas are now color indicated blue in the drawing area. Final result has improved perimeter fitting of the IGA edge UVW on the initial geometry. Moving to the crash and safety discipline. In ANSA version 24.1, there is a notable decrease in the time required to load LS-DYNA files compared to ANSA version 24.0. Time improvement is more than 30%. Elimination of graphical noise from the previous to the current representation of constrained nodal rigid bodies has been achieved. Improved visualization of rigid constrained entities as dashed line connects the COG of the rigid parts. A library with folding tools is now available. A preview of each tool is shown upon selection. The user can add more files in library directory. Upon input of the folding tool, the user has more options to position the tool in the desired position, like for example the scaling option. Moreover, a reference node is created, if not already existed, which is the point where all the boundary prescribed motions apply. In the setup step, the available entities were adjusted in order to be possible to create more complex folding scenarios. In addition, many processes like for example the calculation of the mass moment of inertia take place automatically in the background and assigned to the corresponding entity. Passenger airbag modeling plugin has undergone a massive update. Extra and mount fields are now optional. Automatic beam creation is now independent of base PID shape step. This means user can directly go for beam creation if already base shaping is done. Automatic beam creation now opens a window for handling side panel symmetry and also has option to allow only one panel for treatment. Beam integrity button provided within the tool via check manager. Script is provided inside auxiliaries folder which can be updated by user. The table shows the differences between the checks revealing that the parametric in version 24.1.0 is even faster than the parametric in version 24.0.0 by demonstrating time improvements exceeding 50%. Moving to durability. The FE representation type Y-joint shell has been enhanced so that the projected feature line can be an inner FE or macro perimeter. This new feature allows the generation of seam welds on features like fillets. The adhesive faces can now be massively meshed with the batch mesh tool. The selection and assignment to different meshing sessions or scenarios is done through the PIDs of the adhesive faces. The definition of an enriched feature is now supported in ANSA to enable modeling cracks with non-conforming mesh using the extended finite element method, known as XFEM. The keywords enrichment, enrichment activation as well as initial conditions type equals enrichment are now supported during input and output. A new function to automatically calculate the revolution axis of the 3D circumferential surface smoothing definition for contact pairs has been introduced. In addition, a visual inspection is provided through a characteristic representation. When the faceted surfaces of a contact pair are diverging from the true curved surface, inaccuracy in contact interaction may appear. Surface smoothing is a method to mitigate this effect. The interface for the abacus import keyword has been enhanced, allowing the better handling of imported entities. In the composites field now, the RV generator tool has been enhanced. Now, multi-phase RVEs containing more than two phases, as long as single-phase microstructures can now be homogenized by the tool. Additionally, new RV types are available. Lattice and honeycomb microstructures can be created through the RV generator. The actions of geometry generation, meshing, analysis setup and FE homogenization are now available for these new types. Moreover, for microstructures that are homogenized with epilysis, 3D polar plots of the homogenized material properties are available. The interface between ANSA and RITOMO has been enhanced in the direction of bridging the CT and CAE. RITOMO can process CT scans and export a voxel mesh model and fiber orientation tensors with material volume fractions per element. With the use of ANSA results mapper, this information can be mapped, and material homogenization can be applied on to a structural model. The results mapper can now perform mapping of material orientations and material homogenization from the information that comes from RITOMO and CT scan data. New developments are introduced also in the optimization field. Optimization tool now offers the ability to include user responses by selecting a user-defined text file of a format similar to ANSA responses. After the file is selected, the user responses will appear in the respective area of the optimization tool. Moving to the Optimizer tab, the tool sees the addition of a new optimization algorithm for multi-objective optimization studies, namely NSGA2. This algorithm supports constrained and unconstrained optimizations with both RSM-assisted and direct methods. With the addition of this new algorithm, users can plot Pareto fronts from multi-objective optimization runs. Another addition to the optimization tool is the ability to save and load parameters of an optimization algorithm in a file in order to test different parameter configurations for the optimization studies. Regarding the morphing module, PM member saw some minor enhancements, including the addition of a special flange ending of rectangular shape. The Morph Contacts tool also saw improvements to its functionality related to the efficiency and effectiveness of the algorithm. Moving to epilysis. Following the implementation of the structural and acoustic intensity in version 24.0.0, in this version we have introduced the structural intensity calculation for transient response. The user has the ability to see the vibration intensity, or how the power flows through the model during the simulation. Regarding the contacts in version 24.1.0, a series of updates and contact algorithm fixes were introduced. For the new features, the interference simulation has been introduced, through the support of the center field on the BCompert card. For the participation factors, in this version along with some updates in the AMLS, the participation factors calculation is also done when AMLS is used for the frequency response analysis. This includes all participation factors like grid, panel, and modal participation factors. In the field of SPH now, the full coupling of SPH simulation with rigid body solver is now supported, offering a more accurate solution and broadening the application field of the solver. There are numerous examples of solid-fluid interactions, such as the buoyancy effects created by water in weighting channel testing. Photorealistic visualization can be achieved with the embedded path trace machine. All the visual properties of the bodies, such as color, roughness, and the metallic effect, are chosen to render the image. A novel approach of surface tension calculation leading to more accurate results is included in the latest developments of the SPH solver. This new model is more consistent with the laws of physics, defining interparticle forces so that physical values of the surface tension coefficient can be used. Rain generator is now supported, accessed from the particle sources section. Little cones are drawn in the particle source plane, indicating the location where the droplets will be generated. The performance of the solver has been improved, achieving up to 5 times faster simulation for large-scale applications. The ANSA extended reality capabilities are amplified. A new hand menu is now available in AR. It offers a shortcut button to invoke the tablet, as in VR, with all the functionalities available. Moreover, functions for which the user has already set button shortcuts in the VR settings do also appear in the invoked hand menu. Finally, while inside a function, its respective suboptions will also appear in the hand menu. The positioning of human body models is now possible in VR. Besides body articulation, the users have visibility control over the body layers, like the skin, flesh, skeleton, etc. After the model positioning, penetration checks can be executed to ensure that the model is ready to run. Moving to molding. Now, interpolated 3D curves are created automatically by the tool, trying to best fit into the WeldLines nodes cloud, coming from the result file of the solver, which are already mapped by this tool so far. At the operation of gathering the shell elements which describe the weld lines, now the tool maps the meeting angle from the weld line nodes onto the elements. The information is stored in the element's name, and also a new fringe is created. All properties representing the same molding component, e.g., runner or coolant channels, etc., will be drawn under the same color. User can make focus operation on these components from the index. Check the local thickness according to the activated fringe bar. Make focus operation through the fringe in order to isolate, for example, areas of specific thickness range. Define BC's attributes directly on shell elements instead of points. The drawing is also relevant. The drawing on shells is simpler. And finally, some improvements that regard user productivity. For the LS Dynadeck, the neighbor tool now supports the option to select which hidden entity's connectivity will be considered. When importing a LS Dyna file in ANSA that consists of includes, all the changes applied on the include structure is now recorded and accessed through the Find Changes option in the includes list right-click menu. The Run Solver functionality is now enhanced with a jobs list to enable monitoring and control from multiple jobs. Any job submitted is now persistent and may be accessed and monitored by any running ANSA session. So even after quitting ANSA, jobs may be monitored by launching a new session and running once again the Run Solver function. A running job may be monitored through the data files and plots that are updated live during execution. It may also be suspended, resumed, or terminated upon demand. Moreover, the message handling for notifications, warnings, and errors is applicable for any of the completed or running jobs by setting a job as current and reviewing the issues lists. Any relevant entities that are referenced in a message are also highlighted on the screen. The Adventure Cluster Solver is now integrated inside ANSA interface. A dedicated module has been developed, enabling the definition of boundary, loading conditions, and contacts needed for the model setup of linear and nonlinear structural and heat transfer analysis. The level of interoperability between Abacus and Apilisys Nastran DEX has been improved drastically with the enhancement of automatic translation functionality. More specifically, a plugin is available to perform the conversion of supported entities from Abacus to Nastran. The definition of load case assistant is necessary for the initiation of the conversion. Additionally, a revert functionality is available to delete all the entities that have been created during the conversion. The supported types of analyses to be translated automatically are static and frequency for the time being. Furthermore, the direct submission of Abacus load cases to Apilisys is now available. The LS Dyna template checks has now an optimized listing of the warnings and errors, allowing the user to navigate quickly among any issues of the model. Callback script functions can now be defined via the newly introduced corresponding fields to run before and after realization when realize is applied. Pre-realization and grouping function, a function can be set to run on all connections, in order to create groups of connections to be realized in batches. Pre-realization group actions function, it will run actions and assign parameters for each group of connections. Post-treatment function, it will be called once on all connections after the post-realization to apply extra treatment. User actions are also available for connection entities, in the same way that exist in other lists like in model browser. A new, Vertical Layout is now available for the Connection Manager window. The FE representation settings, the connectivity, as well as the user attributes and XMCF data are listed in tabs in the lower part of the window. This is also the default layout now, when the Connection Manager window is docked. It is now possible to check the quality of the resulted FE of the realized seamline connections via newly introduced checks for the FE rep and heat affected zone step length width and angle deviation. Further checks will be available in future versions. This completes the latest updates of version 24.1.0 of ANSA. Thanks for watching.